A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th Feb, on the front page you have government set to host another visit by foreign diplomats to Jammu and Kashmir. So several EU envoys, European Union envoys, have expressed willingness as such to visit Jammu and Kashmir. So we know that there will be EU-India summit now. External Affairs Minister Mr. Jaishankar is also going to be in Europe, in Brussels, in the capital, EU capital. So ahead of that, now several EU envoys have expressed willingness to visit JNK. This is Supreme Court not in a hurry to hear government pleas on execution. So Supreme Court has conveyed that it is in no hurry to hear the appeals filed by the Centre and the National Capital Territory of Delhi for permission to separately execute Nirbhaya convicts. So it said Nirbhaya convicts had 7 days to exhaust remedies now. So we are seeing this, how the central government has intervened to expedite the process of hanging of the convicts in Nirbhaya gang rape case. And below you have Modi lauds Bodo for peace pact. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that Citizenship Amendment Act would not bring illegal foreigners to Assam. So he has added those fears by speaking out here. So, and below you have Mehbooba was working with separatists. So Public Safety Act dossier based on which former Chief Minister and PDP President Mehbooba Mufti has been booked include public remarks allegedly made by her against the army, pro-militant tweets and attempts to collaborate with separatists. So this is there. And even here CPIM leader Sitaram Yechuri says that Modi has attributed wrong quote to Omar. So Omar Abdullah has also been, the former chief ministers, Mehbooba Mufti, Omar Abdullah, we had seen in news yesterday, have been booked under Public Security Act, the stringent law under which they will be detained for another 3 months and can be detained up to 1 year. So here it is said that, the opposition parties accused Prime Minister Modi of attributing a wrong quote to former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Omar Abdullah, saying it was picked from a satire website. So here you can see, so this satire website faking news. So on this, what had been said was that Mr. Abdullah said dilution of Article 370 would cause a massive earthquake that would divide Kashmir from India. So after this, next day, Public Security Act was, provisions were used, and even Omar Abdullah, former Chief Minister, was booked with 3 months in detention. On page 4, you have plea in High Court against police request for temporary jail. So, petition has been moved in Delhi High Court challenging the police's letter seeking permission from the government to turn Jangli Ram Pahalwan Stadium into a temporary jail for NTCA protesters on the day of assembly elections. So this is a permission which police is seeking from the government, and a petition has been filed on this in the Delhi High Court. On page 8 you have court orders inventory of Sabrimala DT's ornaments. So Supreme Court has appointed retired Kerala High Court Judge CN Ramchandran Nair to prepare a detailed inventory of ornaments of the Sabrimala Temple DT Lord Ayappa. So this detailed list would be handed over to the court in a sealed cover. So the order was initiated on the advice of Kerala government, and court has asked the state's opinion on keeping the ornament safe. You can see it's worth lakhs of crores of treasure, which is there. We have seen in another temple, which is Shri Padmanabhaswamy temple. So Supreme Court had earlier secured treasure of this temple too. So now Sabarimala temple has been asked to prepare an inventory of the ornaments of the deity. And below you have TTD team to finalize temple site in Jammu. So this is Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam. So a team from here, Tirumala, visited Jammu and Kashmir, and they are going to finalize a temple site. A temple for Lord Venkateshwara. A Venkateshwara temple would be built here in Jammu by them. On page 9, you have tourists shun Southeast Asia's new coronavirus spreads. So there's 50% drop in demand from Indian travelers too. Kerala faces spate of cancellations as well after infections. So tourism to Southeast Asia, tourism to Kerala has been affected by new coronavirus. And here you have upgraded 155 mm artillery gun handed over to army. So this is Ordnance Factory Board which handed over Sharang, the first 130 mm M46 artillery gun upgraded to 155 mm to the Indian Army. It was formally handed over by the Ordnance Factory Board Chairman to Army Chief at the ongoing Def Expo in Lucknow. And this is habitat loss felled leopards. So India's leopard population may be only 1/10 of what it was a little over a century ago, but they are experiencing catastrophic declines, and this is due to human pressures, habitat loss. So here you can see there is habitat loss, humans poaching, and even availability of prey has been affected, which they feed on. So this is a concern. So for tigers, we have Project Tiger. So similar project is required even for leopards, is highlighted. Research points to 90% loss of population compared to a century ago. On the editorial page, the first editorial is extended folly. So this is regarding detention of former CMs under Public Safety Act in Jammu and Kashmir. So it says this will delay return to normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir. And below you have Trump moves on. So this is regarding how impeachment could not take place against Donald Trump. So despite the seriousness of the charges, US President is stronger after the acquittal. And the lead article is the high cost of raising trade walls. So this is regarding how an economically interconnected and technologically inseparable world, in such a world too, trade walls are being raised, restrictions, trade barriers are being placed. So India needs to have an open mind on trade is what this article highlights. And this is upholding the fairness of the sentencing process. So this talks about the Nirbhaya case in which the government has intervened to expedite the hanging. So judicial process demands dispassionate equity that gives due regard to substantive requirements of sentencing. So eventually, if the convicts are not going to be given any mercy and curative petitions are going to be rejected, and eventually they're going to be hanged in some time. So the judicial process has to be followed. It has to be given due regard is what this says. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have this Ground Zero coverage. So this article is the long wait for maternity benefits. So this is regarding Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, which was announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi 3 years ago. So it offered a lifeline to pregnant mothers. But in Gujarat's tribal district of Dahod, mothers are struggling to receive the entitlements because scheme is getting entangled in bureaucratic maze of paperwork. So this is how even a 20-month-old died and the mother mourns her death. She could have been saved if timely intervention was brought in the form of Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. So how National Food Security Act has been, deepened, and arbitrary restrictions have been removed, and cash benefits as such are there in Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana only for the firstborn. So such restrictions have to be removed is what this article also says. So this is important. Then on page 12 you have Supreme Court stays JJB proceedings against minor in Kathua case. So this is Juvenile Justice Board. So the proceedings which are going on against a minor allegedly involved in sensational gang rape and murder case of 8-year-old nomadic girl in Kathua. So Supreme Court has stayed the proceedings here, and this is because Jammu and Kashmir administration claimed that Jammu and Kashmir High Court had erroneously affirmed the order of a trial court holding him as juvenile at the time of offense in 2018. So here you can see, despite a notice to the minor accused issued even by the Supreme Court on the administration's appeal, Juvenile Justice Board had continued its proceedings against the accused, treating him as a juvenile. You can see now Supreme Court has stayed the proceedings before the Juvenile Justice Board. And this is include gender bias in a scope of law to curb sexual harassment. So it talks about how gender discrimination has to be removed. so that sexual harassment also ends. And this is credit debit card details of 4 lakh Indians up for sale. So this is Central Emergency Response Team India, which has alerted to which has been alerted to stolen data on offer on darknet. So 98% out of a large packet of sensitive credit and debit card details that have been put up for sale on the darknet are those of Indian customers. So this is Group IB, Singapore-based cybersecurity company which has revealed this. Earlier we had seen even a Germany-based cybersecurity company had revealed how Indian information is available on darknet. And now this is another cybersecurity firm from Singapore claiming this. On page 13, you have Mahinda Rajapaksa to meet Modi today. So trade and defense issues would be discussed. So this will prominently come in news too when the visit and the meeting takes place. Then on international page, you have this coverage on coronavirus, and this is regarding Pakistan Parliament. It has called for public hanging of child molesters. So rights organizations have slammed the move. So public hanging of convicted child killers and rapists. So it's a backlash from human rights organizations on such a provision. Then below you have trade deal before Trump visit not a given. So gaps between India and US positions over a trade deal have not been closed, and USA remains hopeful of a deal, but President Trump is going to visit India in a few weeks, but then there are still issues which have not been resolved. So President Trump markets himself as a negotiator and closer of deals. So signing a trade deal while in India is likely to be an important aspect of Mr. Trump's visit too. Here you can see the issues which are there. You can see is about the new tariffs as such, which India has also put. So there's a cess on medical devices which has been announced, a health cess of 5%. So except those exempted from basic custom duty. So this is to help local manufacturers and finance health infrastructure. So currently duties on medical devices are in the range of 0 to 7.5%, and custom duty increase on a number of agricultural goods is also there, including walnuts, some dairy products like cheese and butter. So US industry lobbies and officials have repeatedly complained about tariffs in India. And that's why President Trump also revoked GSP benefits for India because of inadequate market access in India. So this is there. Should be able to recollect the generalized system of preferences GSP was revoked in June 2019. So under this, developing countries are given preferential access to US market. So India should remove, you know, such trade restrictions, market restrictions is what USA demanded, so that it can enjoy the benefit of GSP in USA. And GSP was actually revoked, and India has brought in further tariffs also in the present budget. On business page, you have government mulls enhancing audit independence accountability. So government has proposed significant amendments to existing regulations to enhance independence and accountability of auditors. So this is in the backdrop of instances of many auditors and auditing entities coming under the regulatory lens for alleged misdoings. So a consultation paper has been brought forth by the government. So it suggests, it has suggestions for curbing 5 threats for the independence of auditors. So like, self-interest, threats pertain to self-interest, self-review, advocacy, familiarity, and intimidation. So there are big 4 auditing firms, PricewaterhouseCoopers, Deloitte, EY, and KPMG. So these are referred to as the big 4, which operate in India through a network of local chartered accounting firms. And this is, in a first, LIC's new business premium crosses 1.5 lakh crore. So Insurance Behemoth LIC, which will be going public in this financial year, has seen its new business premium crossing 1.5 lakh crore milestone for the first time in history. Gross NPAs now, gross non-performing assets now are only 1%. And below you have, this we already know, this is related to budget, that new taxation policy is not going to benefit high net worth individuals. And this is again regarding deposit insurance, which has been announced, that your deposit in banks, it is insured earlier up to 1 lakh. Now it has been increased by the budget to up to 5 lakh. So this has already been covered in the budget. And this is UK court asks Anil Ambani to pay $100 million. So Reliance Group Chairman Anil Ambani has been asked to pay $100 million within 6 weeks towards a conditional order granted to three Chinese banks pursuing the recovery of over $680 million owed to them as part of a loan agreement. So this is the mess which Anil Ambani's Reliance firm is in. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, ahr.com. Thank you.